Assalamu alaikum, welcome to Live with Hassan Akhtar. Our today's lesson related to class 9th, unit number 1, name of the unit, matrices and determinants. Dear students, today we are going to solve multiple choice questions with suitable explanation. Today's first objective statement says the order of matrix 2, 1 is. Students, order of matrix you already know, it is number of rows multiplied by number of columns. Number of rows is this horizontal arrow direction, whereas this vertical arrow indicates the first column, it contains element 2, whereas the second column, it contains element 1. So we see that here is one row and two columns, so what is its order? It must be well obvious, 1 by 2. So let's see what is our answer. It is option B as explained. That is, the order of matrix is number of rows multiplied by number of columns. Next is a matrix having elements row wise, square root 2, 0, 0, square root 2 is called dash. Dear students, you know that if the main diagonal entries, these are same and are other than 1, then the matrix is called scalar matrix. So our answer in this case must be option C. You can see option C is the answer. Going ahead towards the third objective, statement says that which is order of a scalar matrix. Dear students, you know that in a scalar matrix, number of rows and number of columns are equal, which according to these four options is option D only. Here is 2 by 2 means there are 2 rows and 2 columns. So option D is my correct answer. Fourth objective, order of transpose of the entries of this matrix row wise are 2, 1, 0, 1, 3, 2 is dash. Dear students, here the given matrix has order 3 by 2. In case of transpose, rows and columns will be interchanged. That will become 2 by 3. That is, option D will be my answer in this case. As you can see, option D is the answer. So we go ahead for next objective number 5. Adjoint of 1, 2, 0, minus 1 is dash. Viewers, adjoint is calculated like looking at the main diagonal entries, we interchange them, and the remaining diagonal entries we just change the signs. That means minus 1 will take place of 1 and 1 will take place of minus 1. Sign of 2 will become minus, whereas 0, there is no need to put sign minus with 0 because it remains 0. So according to this explanation, the most suitable according to given four options becomes the option A. You can see option A is my answer. We go ahead towards the next objective, that is objective number 5. Number 6, sorry, product of two matrices. First one is XY or row matrix, whereas second one is a column matrix 2 minus 1. Viewers, how we multiply? We put an arrow in the first matrix in horizontal direction, whereas in the second matrix we put an arrow in the vertical direction. Then we multiply the first element with the first element. Between we need to put a sign plus, but if the next sign is minus, plus into minus will become minus. So multiplying 2 and x we get 2x, whereas multiplying with minus 1 with y, our answer will become 2x minus y. You can see that option C is the correct answer. Next objective, that is number 7. If determinant of 2, 6, 3, x is equal to 0, what will be the value of x? What we need to do, we multiply 2 with x and then minus 6 into 3. That is, we have 2x minus 18 is equal to 0. Shifting 18 to the other side, we have 2x is equal to 18. Dividing both sides by 2, we have x is equal to 9 as the answer. Our last objective of this unit number 8, if x is equal to minus 1, minus 2, 0, 1, which is equal to, sorry, if x plus minus 1, minus 2, 0, 1 is equal to 1, 0, 0, 1, then x is equal to, we will keep the matrix x over here. We will shift this matrix on the other side of the equality. This sign plus will go minus. In other words, all these entry signs will be changed. So we will be having situation 1 plus 1, that will make 2, 0 plus 2, that will make 2, 0 plus 0 will remain 0, whereas 1 minus 1 will make as a 0. So out of these four options, the correct option becomes option D. Hope you understand these kind of objectives. Thank you very much.